I would like to show you how this asset listing fee works in the DAO. And I thought it's the easiest to show it directly in the UI, how it's implemented now. And the basic concept is that when a new asset gets listed, by default, it's deactivated and they have to pay a listing fee. They can define freely how much they want to pay. It's defined per the fees. Defined per day. At the moment, it will be one BSQ per day, and they can choose how many days they want to pay. And the days are then used for a trial period. So, in this trial period, the trade activity is not checked. So, the coins stay listed independent if it's traded or not. After the trial period, this time will be used for the lookup period where we are looking back. Or if there have been any trades in this time, and the minimum trade volume need to be 0.01 Bitcoin. This values this zero, so the minimum trade volume and the fee per day can be changed over voting in the DAO. And yeah, when for instance, let's make an example with Aqua coin, it's at the moment delisted because it was never traded. when to start, they need to pay a fee. Let's say they just want to pay for 10 days and they get motivated their community to trade. I have to create a block here locally. So now it's in the trial period for 10 days. And now users can trade. So let's go to account and altcoin account and create an address. I copied here an Aqua coin address, Aqua chain address. And I use it so I can make a trade between both users. Of course, it doesn't make sense that both have the same address here, but doesn't matter for demonstration purposes. So let's, okay, there's no price defined, no idea what's the price here. Let's make one trade. And Bob is taking this offer, and we can see it now. The trade volume should be changed here after the trade is taken. I think it's a little bit delayed. Or do I need to create an? I know, I think it's quite delayed. There's some debug code where it's delayed for 20 seconds or so, but there you will see it there after a while that the trade volume go, yeah, now to one Bitcoin. And yeah, with that they have reached already with this period the trade activity, so they will have done the trade activity with the lookup period. So when we jump forward to the next 10 blocks, yeah, now we have passed this 10 days. At the moment I have set one day with one block, but in relative will be then 144 blocks for one day, of course. And because it's traded, it stays active. When it would not have been traded, then it would go back to delisted due inactivity, and anyone can pay the fee again. Of course, it doesn't have to be the project owner or the coin issuer. Anybody can do this fee payment, and it's always the latest fee payment which counts. So when two or three people are paying at the same time, that will not help. It's not summed up. It's always the latest fee which is used, and then again, it's used for this trial period, and after the trial period, it's used for this look back period. So the longer or the more fee one pay, the better he has the chance to stay listed, because then, yeah, it's easier to have this trade volume in the last 20 or 30 days instead of the last 5 days. Yeah, thank you for listening, and I hope that gave an idea about this fee listing concept. And yeah, if you have any feedback, let me know.